Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. सलाकयाचक्षुरुन्मीलितान्येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो। महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदाय कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्याय गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकाय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय सदभक्ताय नमो। तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नय माम चरणं। माय मिलियंस ऑफ साष्टांग दंडवत प्रणति इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय श्रील गुरुदेव ओम विष्णु पार्षिशु भक्ति प्रज्ञान के सेम इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय शिक्षा गुरु ओम विष्णु पार्षिशु भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज। We will again continue to explain about Ratha Jatra. But before that, I want to tell some important things and you should carefully hear that Krishna has, there is a promise of Krishna, or Shastra tells like Vrindavanam परित्यज्य पादमेकं न गच्छति। दैट कृष्ण ऑलवेज बीइंग इन वृंदावन नेवर वन स्टे बियॉन्ड ब्रजमंडल नेवर एंड नेवर। सो ही नेवर गोज आउट ऑफ वृंदावन और ब्रजमंडल। His power, Radhani Shakti, Srimati Radhika. Does he go? Can she go? Krishna even may go. But she cannot go beyond Brajmandal. She will be always here in Brajmandal. So, either Krishna, neither Radhika, they will come out of Brajmandal. Even 1 inch, even Vrindavan and Mathura is very near each other border. Only a line, fine line is there between them. But Krishna cannot go there. And Radhika cannot go there. In Mathura even. So, we see that there is some vyog, separation mode. Krishna is also weeping bitterly in Dwarka. And Radhika is bitterly weeping in separation mode, rolling down on the earth, weeping bitterly in Nandagaon. If Radha and Krishna always in Vrindavan, how separation mode comes? There should be no separation mode. But yet we see even in Nandagaon, in Brajmandal too, Srimati Radhika and her Sakhi are feeling so much high class of separation. Even they roll down on earth, peeping little, lean thing, not taking anything. She is doing her living the test by any cotton. Dhav went and saw how they are feeling separation. They are very suffering, much, very suffering. So who was weeping? Especially Krishna went to Kurukshetra for this Raj Yatra is going on. And all Brajavasi went there. Radhika with her all Sakhis who went there and meeting with Krishna. And she is telling, you are same Krishna and same Radha, same month or season, Vasantari to Chaitra, or meeting is there, here, but I am not happy. I want that where on the Nikunja tat of Jamuna is her hand. Kakku Jarsingh, he got down singing. Pitiful, sweet Vrindavan. Where? Oh, the very most fragrance of Kadamba trees with Jamuna priest coming. I want to meet there. There is no controller, no father, mother, anyone in that kun, only we Sakhi. In Parkiya mood, we used to meet. But now, who is repenting? Who is repenting there? Also a question may come. Oh, Vrindavan, Rohini Nandan, Ram, always with Krishna, Yashoda Nandan. He cannot give up Vrindavan. And inch to, then who is that Baldev who went to Mathura with Krishna? Where Krishna and Baldev? And after that, with Krishna, he went to Dwarkapuri. Oh, Krishna and Baldev, that Baldev. Who are that Baldev? The Rohinandan Ram, he cannot go an inch out of Vrindavan. Always with Krishna. Yashoda Nandan Radha Kant Krishna, he will be there. But where there? In Dwarka, who is making Krishna weeping so bitterly? And Roni Maya. And Krishna weeping, weeping, and he became senseless. Who is that Baldev? Oh, there are so many questions. I think that all we cannot understand whether I am speaking so much, so much. But only high class of devotees can realize something. But yet I am telling, I don't know why I am telling. This is my habit, bad habit. I want to forget everything, management and what all bogus things. And I want to emerge and weep bitterly, like gopis, for Krishna. And to serve Radhika and become very happy to control Krishna. That he should order me, oh, be on the door of Kunj and let not Krishna come in. So this question and answer are very vital. Sometimes something Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Rupa Goswami too, has given some indication, some line, thought of this line. Who were they? Because if they are going out of Vrindavan, then what promise has been done, then it cannot be kept. Then all Shastra will be what? Mithya. False. Also, for Mathura it has been told, Jatra san nihito hari, nityam san nihito hari. Hari is always there, Vrindavan, in Mathura. He never goes out of Mathura. Then who was in Vrindavan? Who came from Vrindavan? Who went from Mathura to Vrindavan and who came? It is so. And also for Dwarka Krishna it has been told. Same thing. Dwarkadhish never goes out of Vrindavan. Always and always vegetating. Oh, very mysterious all this. Oh, you should know. Jogmaya Purnamasi is very tricky. No? Very tricky. And he has a black jadu.
Magic.
She knows it. She is expert in black magic. Magician. But who is she? Only the wish of Krishna. So Krishna wish becomes Purnamasi. Krishna himself, controlled by himself. Oh, he is dancing. All are dancing. Krishna is dancing, Radha is dancing. All the Brijvasis are dancing. Only by the ishara of Jogmaya. Like a Kathputali
puppet
dance according to the magician, not magician, what?
Puppet.
We cannot see that why it is dance, they are dance. So Krishna, Radhika, whole Brajavasi, all are dancing. Oh, Dwarkadhish, Mathuradhish, all are dancing. And Jogmaya Purnima is making them all. Now come to the point, some answer. That Krishna and Radhika never goes out of Vrindavan. But why feeling separation in Nandagaon? To whom?
Uddhav.
But realized and saw it with his own eyes. Oh, this is Biyogini Radha. Biyogini Radha. And who met in Kurukshetra with Krishna and weeping and wanted to bring Krishna from Kurukshetra to Braja? Who was she? Oh, Sanjogini. After a long time they are meeting, so Sanjogini. And Biyogini, feeling separation. Krishna is not in Vrindavan. So, don't shut your eyes. Say it like me.
Don't go in front.
Always, I will tell you to stand up on bench. Always you should know. You should just sit like this and this and sleep. Otherwise I will take you out of class, those who will sleep. You should not neglect very valuable things. So, what I was telling? So, Srimati Radhika is in Braja. No? In Braja. And Krishna is in Braja, but in hidden way. There, Yogini, always lamenting, all gopis and Radhika especially. So in Braj, with meeting with Krishna, is Vrishabhanu Nandani himself. And those they are feeling so much separation for Krishna, she is Yogini. And after a long time, who met with Krishna in Kurukshetra, again, but not satisfied, she wanted to take Krishna in Vrindavan and brought on her chariot of heart. She is called Sanyogini. In same way, Krishna, Nandanandan, Jasodanandan, Radhakam, oh, always in Braja. And in Mathura, who goes? Huh? Who goes? Vasudev Nandan, Vasudeva Nandan. He goes to Mathura. So, in Mathura and Dwarka, Krishna is Yogi Krishna. Yogi Krishna. And who went to Kurukshetra, he is Sanyogi Krishna. Yogini, Yogi. Sanyogini, Sanyog. In this way. And what about Baldev? Always being in Vrindavan, Brajmandal, he is son of Rohinandan. He never goes out of Vrindavan, always with Krishna. So he is Rohini Nandan. And who goes to Mathura and Dwarka, he is? No. Who is he? He is Devaki Nandan. Devaki Nandan, not Rohini Nandan. But one can tell that he was first in the womb of Devaki and went to, like, Shankarshan. So, here, Baldev Prabhu, who was in Mathura, he is Devaki Nandan. And who was in? No, Dwarka also. And in Vrindavan? He is Anshi of both Baldevs. But three are different by nature. One, but Jogmaya is making all these things. So when he is in Vrindavan, he is Rohini Nandan himself, Ansi of all. And then in Mathura and Dwarka, who is he? Devaki Nandan. But Mool Shankarshan. Mool Shankarshan. Brajmandal, no Shankarshan. In that way. Only mood is there that you took anyhow from the womb of Devaki to Rohini or Krishna to. So he is Sankarshan, but no function others. Only function some, but not any form there. And when he goes to Dwarka, then he becomes Mool Shankarshan. And in Vaikuntha, Maha Shankarshan. And when he goes in his manifestation on the ocean, Viraja, that Karnadasakshai, then he becomes Mahavishnu Karnuta. From Jiva's conditions. and then he becomes Garbhodasai, and then becomes, and in the last he becomes Shesh. So many functions of, we should know all these things. Then you can understand all these things. But I think that when we go out of class, you will forget all. But try to know down on your heart. Otherwise, you'll mix hacha pacha and all that. So, same, Gaurasundar, Sachinandan Gaurhari, in Gaurmandal, Navadip Dham. Oh, he is Sachinandan. But when he goes to Puri, then Piyogi Krishna, always lamenting, lamenting, weeping, weeping, weeping.
Piyogini
father. And when he comes to where? Godavari and Sundarachalam. Sundarachalam Gundicha Mandir. Then what he becomes? Oh, Sanjogi. Then he meets again that Dhuva, Seito Pranath, fine dancing and singing and weeping. So these are the things. You should not talk. And then you should go in bhajan. This is called bhajan. Now we should come on the point again. What? Oh, Rath was going on. Sometimes Gaurhari aage chale ki
dhire aage chale sam hoy sam chale dhire
na gaur jodi piche aage chale
sam chale
dhire aur sam rahe dhire
sam chale dhire
aur jodi sam gaur jodi paache chale sam hoy sthire. If Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sachinandan Gaurhari is dancing
in front of chariot,
then Jagannath
moving forward slowly.
Forward. Oh, very
slowly.
Sing, looking the dance, and very happy with the his core of eyes, smiling. And when Sachinandan Gaurhari sing, oh, behind, oh, why should I go? For whom I should go? You are here. So, the Rath Yatra was going on. Here Krishna is what? Sanjogini. Like, finish your prayer. And singing so much and very happy. Very happy. Or doing so many pastimes there. Apurva.
Apurva?
In the meantime, he was dancing and dancing, he became tall. But still he continued. Sat Damodar, Raya Ramananda. Tesajat Mahaprabhu is now tired. We should give him
rest.
So he stopped the chariot and told that, where? Balgandi, I Tota, or garden of Jagannath, informed. And he told the Pujari, head Pujari, and others that anyone can offer any bhog from anywhere. So, all the devotees, all the assembled persons, devotees, they began to give offerings. Some narikel of Jagannath. Thousands and thousands. And some prasadam. And Jagannath began to take from his eyes everything, every corner, here, there, back, everywhere. and Maitri, Sarva Damodara Ramananda to Nityananda Prabhu to Mahaprabhu, and that garden, and Mahaprabhu are tall. So he was lying down on a tree, keeping his head on the tree. And what doing? Always remembering this, that past times of Vrindavan. And he was weeping, tears coming. In the meantime, Sarvam Bhattacharya, Sarva Damodar, especially Raman, told the king that now this is the time. You should change your royal dress and be like a simple devotee with one dhoti. You should go there and recite the slok of Bhagavatam Gopi Gita. And then he will be merciful. He will embrace you and your all desire will be fulfilled. So in disguise, he did pranam to Nityananda Prabhu, Advaita Acharya, all other devotees, and beg permission, and then he went slowly there and sat on the feet of, near the feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and began to recite. From beginning from first stroke, and when he came on that slope, तव कथामृतं तत्र जीवनं कविभिरीतं कल्मषामं श्रवणमङ्गलं श्रीमदाततं भुवि गृह्णन्ति ते भूरिदा in such a sweet tone. You are hearing my tone. You cannot compare with that. Oh, millions of times more sweet, with tear in ears, eyes. And he began to shout. And began to not miss out. That Mahaprabhu was so much tired, so he was doing like this and singing. Mahaprabhu heard this, his slok especially. And what became? Oh, who are you? Who are you? Without asking, you are giving me so much high class of nectar. And you embraced. Oh, you are giving me. I cannot repay you. I am a beggar, street beggar. I cannot repay you. Be merciful and continue. And then he again continues. Prahasitam priya prema bichadam viharanam chate dhyanamangalam shramanamangalam Shimadatatam Bhogidanti Te Bhogidanti. So, in this way, he continued. But what is the meaning? Krishna Das.
Sridhartha Ramana Hari Govinda Jai.
Yeah.
that Gopis has told before in that previous slok. We are going to die without you. Then Krishna told that, you should die at once, don't delay. Then Gopi said, how we can die? You are the reason that we are not dying. Tava katha amritam, your katha, katha means? Katha means past tense.
Discussion of your
sweet Hari Katha. Oh, this is Amrita, more than nectar, more than heavenly nectar, than Moksha Amrita. Who is dying, about to die, and who will hear the Hari Katha, or name, Roop, Leela, or anything of Krishna. Oh, he cannot talk. Tapta jivan. Those who are suffering so much in their life. Tapta jivan. By hearing the sweet pastimes of katha, discussions, those who are suffering so much, at once ready feel. So much cool. More than bridge. Kabhi pir. Because Brahma, Shankar, and Sukadeva Goswami, Narada Goswami, they all have told the glories of your katha. That anyone cannot die. That is why we are not dying. Kalmash apaham. Anyone here? All kinds of kalmas, anarthas, sins, sufferings, all will go away at once. This is not a poet's imagination. In real sense, it is true to extent. Kalmas abham, samana mangalam. If he is hearing, oh, when he began to hear these past times, oh, mangalam and mangalam. Mangalam, mangalam means auspicious began. From that very moment, all kinds of qualifications, all kinds will come. Whole world he will know that person. His glory will be everywhere. That devotee. Kalpa Mashaham Srimadatam Bhuvi Giridam Kite Bhuvidam. Really, those who are discussing and explaining the sweet pastimes of Krishna, Harikatha, Sri, really in this world they are
greatest donor. Generous donation to everyone.
They are most generous by nature. This is the biggest donation. And you should realize this. You cannot repay me. My associates. Never and never. But one gopi, who is telling this? Chandravya or his Sakhiza. So they are praying to Krishna. Oh, at once you should come. If by your katha it is so, then if you will come, you are now disappeared. So at once you should come. They are praying. But one is very angry by the action of this cruel action of Krishna. She wants to forget Krishna. But she cannot. When Krishna told that, oh, why you are not dying in my separation? oh, this you are responsible for this. At first in our life we are very down. Stand up if you will. Don't sleep. Then Kau katham mritan? With anger she is telling. Why you are not dying? Then she is, you are responsible for that. You are very cruel. Most cruel. And your past and sweet discussion all are more than you. At first we are very happy in our family life. At that time serving our husband, children and all others, father, mother. Oh, we were very, very, very happy. But when first we heard your few past times, at once our life was changed. From begin we died, began to die. Not die, but die. So your past terms are mrita, like very strong poison, more than snakes. And we realize this. Tava katha mritam tapta jivan. What meaning? First told what? She is telling again. Tapta jivan. It makes our life oh so much suffering. Because we are now going to die. So more poisonous than snake poison or others. We realize this. Kavi bhi reeditam. Oh Kavi, this is the keval kalpana. Puri kalpana. Only in imagination, like a poet is writing some poem. What? Oh Jagannath Dev Rath, what touching score. What is the meaning? Was it? Chariot was? But it has been written. Even in Chaitanya Charitamrita, it has been written. Oh, a poet was making some poetry. Oh, the horses of Arjun were floating in the, running in the sky. What is this? Can it be? So, all the poets like this, they have glorified your Harikatha, but really it is very painful. Only this Kori Kalpana hai. It is only imagination of where, of whom? Of who is that? Vyasdev and Sukadeva Goswami. In the end they will tell. Kalma Shahapaham. What first told? Oh, suffering goes away. But she said suffering coming more and more. More and more. Anyone should not hear the past sweet pastimes of Krishna. We'll be like that. Always suffering. If you want to be really happy with your family, don't chant his name. Today. Try to forget that black cheater. And don't hear Harikatha. Tapta jivanam kapi bhiridisham kalmash abham shavana mangalam sarma. This is quite false. By hearing sarna mangalam, oh, auspicious, not against it. If anyone. We have realization this. At first we are happy, but when we heard, oh, our life become up shape and full of suffering. So we have this realization. Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam. Oh, this point is more dangerous. If any devotee shaving his head, putting big, big tilaks, kanti mala big, big here, and harinam chhap, and taking a book named Bhagavatam. They are fearing to tell the name of Bhagavatam. Keeping here and telling, announcing, oh, come on, without any, no price, without free of cost, I will tell this Harikatha. They are who? Most cheater and dangerous and killer. They will spoil your life forever. Don't hear. Remember this always. Who have tilaks? Kanti mala. One book here. Especially if he is saffron cloth. You should do dandar panam and so this gopi is Radhika is telling that be careful from the dangerous person, he and his followers. Don't chant from today, stop what you have done. This. It may be so many more meanings of different group of gopi, different in ways. One gopi is Sukadev Goswami is telling explanation. If Krishna meet gopi, then tau katha amritam. But if Krishna is always with gopis, dancing, singing, and doing all these things, playing with gopis, then his katha is otherwise Gaur Praman. Now come to our mood. That that gopi in Kurukshetra, Radhika, the gopin in Vrindavan, Radhika, is telling to Krishna, you are a great cheater. Abhushyate nanilana padaravin jo gaisvarei ravi sada agad bodham sansar kup tarnavalam. What Krishna is telling, and Radha is telling, and Krishna again answers in beautiful way. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, it has this. You can explain something, touch the mind.
Om Gyanatimurandasya Gyanandanaslakaya Chakshurmulitam jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Sri Gurudev ordered me to speak a few words just to touch the meaning of very beautiful.
That has been told in Chaitanya Charitamrita. In not Vyas, but in Tripadi. Right?
Oh, the very heart-touching conversation, the exchange of loving feelings which took place between Radha and Krishna there at Kurukshetra. When Krishna and Radhika met together and gopis, gopis were somewhat angry with Krishna. Why? Because he told them, Mai bhakti bhutanam amrita
praya kalpate. No, first that I'm everywhere.
He told, why are you feeling upset and feeling separation from me? Because, don't you know, I am all pervading, inside and out. Just as a pot which is made of clay can never be separated from the earth. There was earth, from the earth one pot came. So you can take this pot anywhere, but can it be separated from the earth? No, why not? The pot itself is made out of earth. So, I am all pervading, everything has come from me. Therefore, no one can be separated from me at any moment. But you are thinking that you are separated, why? You should try to control your mind. You should meditate on me. And when your mind becomes steady and in control, then you will realize that I am always with you.
Everywhere.
So when gopis heard this, they became somewhat angry with Krishna. And they told him, Avaschate nalinana bapadara vinda Yogeshwarare divachintara gadabodhe Sansara kupapatito taranavalambam Geham dusham apimanasyuti yatsadanaha. In the general sense, the meaning is, Oh, Nalinanabha, you from whose navel came a lotus flower upon which Brahma was born. You know that Brahma and the Yogeshwaras, like Mahadev, Navayogendras, Tatusan, four Kumars, and other great personalities, they have agadha bodha, agadha buddhi, unlimited intelligence, and therefore, ridivichintya, they meditate upon you within their hearts because they're Yogeshwara. They have control over their mind and senses. But as for us, sansara kupa patita, we are fallen ordinary people, we are villagers in household life, and therefore we cannot meditate upon you. So please be merciful, and by your own causeless mercy, may your lotus feet appear in our hearts. This is the outer meaning of what gopis are saying. Always words do not express the direct meaning. For example, if someone is very black, their teeth stick out, they are very ugly, and someone says, Oh, your beautiful smile charms the whole world. What is this? This is an insult. If the father will say to his son, Oh, you are very clever, you should give me lessons in how to do all these things. What does it mean? It means, you are a foolish boy, you don't know anything. Why don't you listen to me? So sometimes we can express one thing by opposite language. It's called Shleshvakya. So in this way, though gopis appear to be speaking very politely to Krishna, their words have an opposite meaning. What is that? Ahushtate nalinanabha padaravinda. Oh, I think that Brahma, he's born from a lotus flower. And this lotus flower is born from mud. So this is his parampara. First Brahma, from him, he came from lotus flower. Lotus flower is called Pankaja, comes from Panka, from mud. And mud is jad, has no sense, no feelings, no intelligence. So Brahma has no intelligence. And this is why, you give him this instruction, you should meditate on my lotus feet. And Brahma says, that's very good, and he goes away and does meditation. Because he's foolish. He does not understand that he's being cheated. Just like a Mohini Murti came and stole the nectar away from the demons. So in the same way, we cannot be cheated by you. You cannot steal nectar from us by telling us you should do meditation as you steal away nectar from so many jnanis, those who follow the path of yoga and meditation. We cannot meditate on your lotus feet. Why? Because we are not accustomed to think of your lotus feet in this way. We have played with you since our childhood. So we know you from the beginning. We know what a cheat you are.
Brahma came from the womb of
the lotus navel.
And that is you. So you are more jad. So from jad you have become.
So Brahma is jad. The lotus from which he came from is more jad. And this lotus came from you. You are more jad. You are the most terrible, most inert and senseless person.
To whom what to tell, you don't know.
You cannot understand what instruction to give to which person. If you take the food for the cows, which is grass, and feed it to a human being, you become laughing stock and everyone will criticize you. So what are you doing? You're taking the instruction which is meant for Yogeshwara and those with vast intelligence and giving to some cowherd girls, gopis, village girls, that have no education, they only know how to collect cows.